Now, despite some NBA players generating hundreds of millions of dollars throughout their professional careers, some have ran through it all and become broke for ridiculous reasons. Now, with Allen Iverson being one of the most popular basketball players of all time, it's definitely surprising to see him on this list after he made around $154 million in his career, but he still came out empty-handed. Iverson was drafted with the first pick in the 1996 NBA draft by the 76ers, and he had a legendary career, going down as one of the best players to never win a ring. Iverson's rookie contract was a deal for 3 years and $8.6 million, and from that point on, Iverson was getting deals like a 4-year contract for $74 million and a 6-year contract for $70 million, which would eventually round his career earnings out to right about $154 million. And with endorsement deals throughout his career, his earnings skyrocketed to approximately $200 million. But stories about Iverson began to surface when a jewelry store in Georgia came out and said that he owed them close to $860,000 and he didn't have the money to pay back the debt. But Iverson wasn't just a casual spender. He apparently had a habit of keeping his money in dozens and dozens of garbage bags around his mansion, and some would just occasionally go missing. At one point in his career, he arrived back at an airport and he had apparently forgotten where he parked his car, so he ditched it and bought a new one. According to TMZ, AI's monthly expenses during his career were pretty unbelievable. It included about $10,000 for clothes, $10,000 for groceries and household items, $10,000 for entertainment and restaurants, and $1,000 for dry cleaning. That's obviously a lot, but it wasn't the most he was running through during his prime. According to a 2012 court filing, it suggested Iverson was burning through around $360,000 per month, with $126,000 going to creditors and mortgages. And at that point in time, Iverson was earning $750,000 annually from endorsements, but even that wasn't enough to cover everything. Former NBA player Matt Barnes got to see Iverson's spending habits up close, and he recently told Sports Illustrated about it. Barnes said, "Allen was the first guy that showed me how an NBA player spends money in the strip clubs. That guy went hard. He throws so much money, and this was when I was first in the league, that I'd take my foot and scoop it under my chair and either re-throw it or put some in my pocket. He threw 30, 40,000 every time we went. I'm like, you realize what I could do with this money?" Reebok actually ended up saving Iverson's life in 2001 when Iverson made a decision that would inevitably save him from his future self. He signed a very unique endorsement deal with Reebok, and in addition to being paid $800,000 a year for life, Reebok set aside $32 million in a trust fund that Allen would not be able to access until he turns 55 in the year 2030. AI doesn't like to admit that he went broke because of the status he at one point reached, but he did sit down with CBS this morning in 2015, and when he was asked about going broke, Iverson said, "That's a myth. That's a rumor." He was then asked which part was a rumor, and he said, "The fact that I'm struggling in any part of my life." Now, with David Harrison making well over 7 figures in his career, he went from the McDonald's All-American game in high school to working at McDonald's just 10 years later. David Harrison was drafted with the 29th pick by the Indiana Pacers in the 2009 NBA draft, and over the course of his 4-year career with the Pacers, he made $4.4 million. But during this time in the league, he didn't prove to be more than a role player, so after his contract concluded with Indiana, he was signed to a Timberwolves practice squad before being waived by them as well. And from that point on, he never played in the league again. He went on to play overseas, but never really found a successful spot in basketball, despite being 7 feet tall. He went on to take a job at McDonald's in 2013, but quit after just 2 weeks and moved on to trading stocks. His financial troubles were no laughing matter, and it affected his family's future. And Harrison recently caught up with Yahoo Sports to talk about his journey from the NBA to broke, where he said, "I was embarrassed because of where I could be in life. Everybody has to work to make a living somehow. I have 2 children. They don't care where I work. They just need to eat." And when he was asked about why he got a night shift job at his local McDonald's, he said, "People were showing up trying to take my car. My house was a foreclosure. I didn't have any income. I just had everything going out. I have child support to one son. I have a really big family and I have to take care of them. Even though I'm not playing in the NBA, I needed money." Harrison was a dominant player in college. Many thought he would turn into an NBA star. And former Colorado forward Chris Copeland talked about Harrison before his NBA career, saying, "I never felt more helpless than when I was guarding him. In college, he was unbelievable. He was a special athlete. He was very misunderstood. He was a smart guy, a deep thinker. When you're that intelligent and that deep with your thoughts, sometimes people don't understand where you're coming from." Anton Walker, who, believe it or not, used to play pickup games at the park in Chicago with Michael Jordan, lost his money after retirement instead of gaining more like his old friend. Anton Walker was drafted by the Celtics with the 6th pick in the 1996 NBA draft, and he signed a 3-year deal worth $5.5 million. Walker started his career with the Boston Celtics and was a 3-time All-Star, and he also won a ring with the Miami Heat. But around 2008, Walker's financial issues began making headlines as he was arrested for writing bad checks related to gambling debts. He owed 6 figures to multiple casinos, and by 2010, Walker filed for bankruptcy. Over the course of his 12-year career, he made approximately $108 million, and he quickly learned that money doesn't last long after buying 2 Bentleys, 2 Mercedes, a Range Rover, a Cadillac Escalade, and a bright red Hummer. By 2010, he had $4 million in expenses, and he was already $12 million in debt, which led to his bankruptcy. Walker met up with CNBC to talk about that time in his life, and it was when he was talking about bankruptcy in particular that he said it was his darkest hour. Walker also told CNBC that instead of hiding behind his problems, he wants to educate others on his mistakes, and he went on to say, "You worked so hard to get to this point. Don't blow it. it. Don't blow the money that comes with it. Remember how hard it was for you to get to that level. Take care of it. Build your team. Make sure you preserve it. It's a tough lesson to learn. I wanted to take care of my family. I wanted to be the best for them. I really didn't have the word no in my vocabulary. It was something I wasn't used to saying. You've got to get the word no in your vocabulary. Walker also talked about wanting to show kids how to map out their future because that's what's most important. He said, create a lifestyle where you're going to have generational wealth. Put together a savings plan where you'll be okay for the rest of your life before you start this lavish lifestyle. If I change 2 or 3 kids' lives, I think my life is a success. Now, Vin Baker wasn't the most legendary player in the league. He played for 7 different teams in his 13-year career, but regardless, he still has an interesting story of blowing through $100 million of career earnings on cars, mansions, yachts, and even gifting multiple crazy presents during the holidays. He eventually retired from the league in 2006, but after playing for over a decade in the NBA, Vin blew through everything. It got so bad that he had to go back to work, and he decided to take a job as a Starbucks manager in Kingstown, Rhode Island. And he thanks Howard Schultz, who's the former Supersonics owner, who gave him that opportunity. Vin spoke about how this job opportunity at Starbucks changed his life, and he said, for me, this could have ended most likely in jail or death. That's how these stories usually end. For me to summon the strength to walk out here and get excited about retail management at Starbucks and try to provide for my family, I feel that's more heroic than being 6'11 with a fadeaway jump shot. I get energy from waking up in the morning and, first of all, not depending on alcohol and not being embarrassed or ashamed to know I have a family to take care of. The show's gotta go on. Baker also spoke about the city of Kingstown and this new job opportunity, saying, I love North Kingstown. It reminds me of my hometown, so it's comfortable. I like this community. Starbucks draws a lot of repeat customers, so many know me now. In this company, there's opportunity for everyone. I have an excellent situation here at Starbucks and the people are wonderful. When you learn lessons in life, no matter what level you're at financially, the important part to realize is it could happen. I was an alcoholic. I lost a fortune. I had a great talent and lost it. For the people on the outside looking in, they're like, wow. For me, I'm 43. I have 4 kids. I have to pick up the pieces. I'm a father. I'm a minister at my father's church. I have to take the story and show that you can bounce back. If I use my notoriety in the right way, most people will appreciate that this guy is just trying to bounce back in his life. That's no doubt Sean Kemp made a name for himself, leaving a legacy as one of the best Supersonics in league history, as well as a ridiculous dunking ability. But recently, he got himself back into the workforce, and it didn't involve basketball. Kemp was drafted by the Supersonics in the first round of the 1989 NBA draft, and he signed deals like his massive 7-year, $107 million contract, but just like the players before him, he ran through all of his career earnings, and he lost most of it to his 7 children by 6 women who demanded a large amount of child support. Kemp recently took a different approach on his work life when he decided to open up a restaurant and a bar that's called Oscars. This place serves food and drinks as well as live musical guests, including DJs, and also has free Wi-Fi. The Oscars website explains the establishment as a neighborhood joint that you won't want to leave. But Kemp recently sat down with the reporter Steve Kelly, who talked to Kemp about bringing a bar and restaurant to the city of Seattle after all the greatness he had in basketball, and Kemp said, it's so touching when you have a connection like this with the city and you see a reaction like that. It reminds me that the people here never got a chance to see enough of me. I never really thought I was anything special on the basketball court or anything special as a man, but the one thing I always thought I could do is give out an extra effort. But what I'm really proud of now is being able to get outside of basketball and still reach out to the community and still give that extra effort out there like I gave on the court. When I hear the cheers now or talk with the people, it keeps me on a straight path. Now, to no surprise, when it comes to questionable decisions made in the NBA, J.R. Smith is always a part of the list. Obviously, he became relevant prior to making the league, but especially while being a ridiculous acrobatic dunker with Denver and New York, eventually transitioning to play alongside LeBron in Cleveland. And after winning a championship, he signed his biggest deal yet, but still finds himself on this list because of financial mistakes that he made early on. One of his biggest mistakes was obviously dribbling out the clock in the NBA Finals Game 1 against the Warriors that left LeBron James raged. But JR blowing the $25 million he made from 2004 to 2011 was his first huge setback. JR was drafted by the New Orleans Hornets with the 18th pick in the 2004 NBA draft, and he instantly signed a 3-year, $3.9 million deal with the Hornets, which lasted until he was traded. And then he signed another 3-year deal worth $16 million with the Nuggets. During this time, JR cashed out on multiple flashy cars, a few mansions, and a bunch of other crazy ones that he had. And by 2011, when the NBA had a lockout, JR was broke. He spent the $25 million that he made up to that point. JR ended up going to China during the lockout in order to still make some money, but his comeback came in 2012 when he signed a deal with the Knicks for $2.5 million. The real money started coming back to JR when he signed a 4-year, $57 million deal with the Cavs in 2016, and ever since, he's spent his money more wisely. Over the course of his career, he spent nearly $700,000 on fines as well from the NBA, which hasn't helped his pocket. At present day, he finds himself sitting in free agency with teams skeptical to give him another chance after so many mishaps already. Now, with Zion Williamson becoming one of the most hyped upcoming athletes we've seen since LeBron, despite multiple deals he signed this past year with the Pelicans after being drafted and Jordan Brand as well, he still finds his way onto this list. Zion signed a massive deal with Jordan, which pays him $10 million a year, And Zion talked about this opportunity when he said, "I feel incredibly blessed to be a part of the Jordan brand family. Since I was a kid, I dreamed of making it to the league and having the type of impact on the game Michael Jordan had, and continues to have to this day. He was one of those special athletes I looked up to, and I can't really express how happy and excited I am for this journey." Michael Jordan himself talked about bringing Zion on, saying, "Zion's incredible determination, character, and play are inspiring. He's an essential part of the new talent that'll help lead the brand into the future. He told us he would shock the world and asked us to believe in him, and we do." Obviously, Zion has made waves in high school and college, which got him drafted with the first pick in the 2019 draft, but before even playing his first NBA game, Zion's battled injury and he wasn't able to start in the team's opener, and he's been out since. The big news, however, has come from the $100 million lawsuit that was filed against him before collecting his first check and before even making an appearance on an NBA court. Zion sued Prime Sports, and Zion insisted that a contract he signed with Prime Sports in April to represent him in endorsement deals is void and illegal under North Carolina's Uniform Athlete Agent Act. The president of Prime Sports sued Zion back and filed an 88-page complaint in the Miami-Dade County Circuit Court against Williamson. Ford and their company demanded at least $100 million in damages, along with other remedies, which is more than he's expected to earn from his NBA contract and Jordan deal. You want to know the real key to just never going broke? All you got to do is click on this video right here on the screen. Boom, bro. You click on that video on the screen, you're pretty much guaranteed to not go broke. Just click on the video, bro. Okay, please. Thank you.